Hey guys, welcome to Impact's first podcast.
Gracias a cada uno de ustedes que están aquí puntualmente para escuchar lo que tiene Dios que hablar por medio de su palabra. Y bueno, vamos a empezar con nuestra serie. Esa serie ya la empezamos la semana pasada y la serie se llama Real y Personal. Esta serie habla de cómo poder tener conocer el carácter de Dios. La semana pasada hablamos acerca del carácter de Dios como redentor. ¿Qué quiere decir redentor? Bueno, aprendimos la semana pasada que Jesús nos libró de la esclavitud del pecado en el que vivíamos. Jesús con su sangre nos redimió del pecado, ¿verdad? Entonces, eso fue lo que aprendimos la semana pasada. Y hoy vamos a conocer otro carácter de Dios, pero el carácter de Dios como Padre. Y entonces, para comenzar con nuestra lección, me gustaría, Moy, que nos ayudaras a orar para comenzarla.
Yeah, we'll have a quick little prayer just to send us to this. Dear Heavenly Father, we just pray that you just, tonight you just open our minds, you give us understanding so that we can speak your word, Father, not ours, so that we may be able to reach people through your word, Father, so it may be you, Lord, touching people's lives and making changes. Thank you for everything. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Okay, so let's jump right into this. So because we are at church, we're going to bring out our Bibles. So go to 1 John 3:1. And I'll give you like 5 seconds. Okay. So 1 John 3:1, it says, "Look at how great a love the Father has given us that we should be called God's children." And we are. And this is the part that I want all of us to kind of focus on. And we'll talk more about this a little bit later on. Okay, so the reason the world does not know us is that it didn't know him. So I want you guys to answer, why is it important to know God? But before we do that, I want to kind of do like a little activity really quick, a really quick activity. Okay, so on this sticky note, and I'll show you guys right now. On this sticky note, I have a celebrity.
Okay,
Moy, so I'm going to put this on you.
All right.
I have a celebrity.
It's gonna be bad.
You have, you can ask me 5 questions about the celebrity.
Okay.
And you have 3 opportunities to guess who this is.
Okay.
Okay? So the people who are just listening to us, go ahead and, yeah. Okay, so the people who are listening to us only, you guys can go ahead and guess along with Moy. And then the people that can see us, I don't know if you can see that really quick.
Okay. I don't know if they can, but
it's kind of, you'll figure it out. Okay, so Moy, go ahead and ask me 5 questions.
Are these just yes and no, or can?
Yeah, they're just yes and no questions.
Is this a guy?
Yes.
Lleva una.
1 question. You got it.
Is he in comedies?
Yes.
Oh, right. Is he in TV shows?
Yes.
Is he in The Office?
Yes.
Oh, great. Now, who from The Office?
1 more question. Choose wisely.
Gracious. Did he? No. And this is tough.
Dun, 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 dun,
is he in the first season?
Yes. Okay, now you have to guess. That's it. That's all your questions you have.
I don't know
his name,
though.
Three guesses. What is it?
I'm really bad with celebrity names. What is?
Dile
can I take? Can I use the character in the show's name? Because I really don't think Michael Scott.
Yes! Woo! We got it. Okay, awesome. So yeah, Michael Scott slash Steve Carell was the guest. Okay, Moy. So would you say guessing who was on your forehead was easy to do?
Guessing it.
Yeah, guessing it.
Kind of.
Okay.
Because I know you like The Office.
True. Okay, so let's take the stance of you not knowing The Office.
Okay.
Okay. So if I told you to live like this person, right, would you be able to do that? If you haven't seen the show, you don't know who that
Even
is.
Even seeing the show, definitely not.
Probably like not, right? He's just a very intense character. But anyways, so I think, so relating that back to what we're talking about, right? So I think that's where the disconnect lies between us and God. You know, we're trying to live the way that Jesus lived, but in the same way, like, right, the way that I asked you.
Right.
How are we going to be able to do that if we don't know him? right? And even if, let's take the other stance, right? If we don't have our identity in him, that can cause issues too. And we're going to go into a little bit later why those cause issues.
Okay.
So the lesson series that we're going to go through, or we're going through, hermana said, it's aimed to answer the question, you know, who is God? So now back to the question. So why would you guys think, or why do you guys think it's important to know God? ¿Por qué es importante conocer a Dios? And don't give away too much of what we're going to talk about, but just kind of like, why? So give it to me in one word. En una palabra.
What?
Dígame por qué. Yeah.
Oh, gosh. Important to know God in one word.
In one word.
Es que está difícil decirlo en una palabra.
Can I use two?
Fine. I'll accept it. I will accept it.
Living right.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's a nice one.
La ganó.
Okay, sure.
Okay, ¿por qué es importante conocer a Dios? Porque Dios es todo.
Okay, everything. Okay. And mine, you guys are going to get mad at me. Salvation, mic drop. I'm not actually going to drop it. But yeah, go ahead, boy.
All right, well, we're going to change it up just a little bit. We're talking about nationalities. The question we have today is, what nationality, if you had the choice or the opportunity, what nationality would you choose to be and why? Entonces, la pregunta sería, ¿qué nacionalidad escogería usted si tenía la oportunidad y por qué?
Yo hubiera elegido ser italiana.
Okay.
Gasps.
Sí. Una, porque me gusta el espagueti, pero no sería por eso nada más. No, me gusta mucho. Ya. Me gusta mucho el país. No he tenido el gusto de conocerlo, pero lo que he visto de él por medio de redes sociales y todo, me encanta. Sí. Los paisajes, o sea, la gente, la calidad de vida que tienen, muy tranquila. Eso me gusta. Nice. Hubiera sido italiana.
Mine is similar. I would also go to Europe. Okay. I would go to France, or I would be French. Just because, like, in high school, I tried to learn French. I tried to learn, French.
Yeah, French.
Sorry. I don't know what I was going to say. Anyways, I did try to learn French. It didn't stick. All I can say is bonjour. And I don't even think I'm not even saying that right. And thank God, like, I got the opportunity to go to France, I think, this past summer. And it was amazing. I just honestly fell in love with it. But yeah, that's what I would choose.
All right, awesome. I guess I wasn't really supposed to answer the question, but I think I would pick South Korea.
Oh.
And the reason being was, one, they do have a pretty decent
Korean barbecue.
Well, there's a Korean barbecue, which is amazing.
Honestly.
Their living conditions are pretty nice. They're not bad. But they have the fastest internet.
Ooh.
So that would be amazing.
Yeah. There's not a monopoly on that. But
yeah. So, I mean, I get to get into it. But, yeah, it sounds pretty cool. True. So, plus the food looks awesome.
It honestly does.
Pues fíjense, qué padre sería, ¿verdad? Poder elegir nosotros. O sea, yo hubiera sido italiana, estuviera así. Fíjense, no me sé ninguna palabra en italiano, pero me hubiera gustado ser de allá.
Espagueti.
Hubiera sido bien padre, pero ¿qué creen? ese es un derecho que solamente a nuestros padres les correspondía, porque pues ya nacimos, ¿verdad? Pero ese es una oportunidad que solamente es para los padres, elegir en dónde van a nacer sus hijos. Aunque nosotros hubiéramos querido poder tener esa oportunidad, pues no. A nuestros padres les tocó decidir por nosotros. Fíjense, en muchos países, los hijos que nacen en el extranjero, por ejemplo, Caro, ¿tú de dónde eres? ¿Dónde naciste?
Orange County.
Are you okay? Sure you were born there
now? Yes, I was. I was just was not prepared for that question. But yes, Orange County.
Okay, en Estados Unidos. ¿En qué país? ¿Y tú, Moy?
¿Dónde nací?
Sí.
Culiacán, Sinaloa.
Oh, ¿tú eres de Culiacán?
Boring.
Oh.
I'm not from here. Well, born anyways. I was not born here.
No, bueno, no importa. Pero ¿sabes lo que importa? Que hablas bien el inglés. Porque desde chico te trajeron para acá.
Ya de las greñas, a un año.
Guau, wow, no, pues sí. Ok, entonces el ejemplo lo voy a usar contigo, Caro. Okay. Tú eres de aquí, de Estados Unidos. ¿Y tus papás?
Mi papá, pues los son de México, a mi papá de Morelos, y mi mamá de Zacatecas.
Ok, fíjate, tú sabías que porque tus papás son mexicanos, ellos, tú tienes el derecho de ser mexicana, o sea, tú puedes agarrar la identidad como mexicana solamente por tus papás.
Yeah.
Al igual que si Moy hubiera nacido en México y tus papás fueran de acá, tú, tus papás automáticamente, o sea, te dan esa oportunidad de ser americano. Entonces, muchos países se puede hacer eso. Y fíjense, así como podemos obtener la nacionalidad de nuestros padres, también obtenemos muchas cosas de nuestros padres. Por ejemplo, los rasgos físicos, los rasgos genéticos. Por ejemplo, ¿a ti te han dicho que te pareces a alguno de tus papás?
Mi papá y Valeria, mi hermana y mi mamá.
A tu mamá,
yeah.
¿Verdad? ¿Y a ti, Moy?
También me han dicho que tengo la cara más como mi mamá.
O sea, siempre heredamos también de nuestros padres como la genética. Wow, tú, genética europea. Pero pues no, mis papás son mexicanos también. Aunque también me vean. No, no se crean, estoy bromeando. Pero entonces podemos tener la identidad genética de nuestros padres, pero no solamente eso, también las costumbres y los gustos. Pero lo que más se me hace importante son los principios y valores. En nuestra casa, por ejemplo, yo cuando yo llegaba a una casa, yo tenía que saludar a todos los que estaban en esa casa, porque a mí me enseñaron un valor, de ese valor de hey, cuando llegues a una casa ajena o cuando llegues a tu propia casa, tú tienes que saludar hasta de mano a cada persona que está ahí. Y quizás a Moy me va a decir, hermana, pero pues a mí nunca me enseñaron eso. A mí me dijeron que nada más con pasar y decir hello y ya con eso. O sea, y son valores diferentes, ¿verdad? Lo que nos enseñaron. O tú cuéntame de un valor que te hayan enseñado en tu casa. Que quizá la gente dice,
bueno,
tal muy vez, raro.
No sé, ¿verdad? Pero siempre me dijeron que no corrija a mis mayores.
¿Que no qué?
Que no corrija a mis mayores.
Es cierto. Sí, cierto. Por ejemplo, a mí otro valor que me enseñaron a que si estaban en la mesa los adultos, yo no podía estar así, escuchando lo que estaban hablando. Mi abuelita, en cuanto me veía así, me hacía unos ojos, me los abría y me decía, y yo ya entendía, sin que me dijera nada más, yo entendía y me salía. Entonces, esos son valores que en otros lugares, por ejemplo, en otras étnicas, pues no es de gran relevancia, ¿verdad? Pero bueno, ahora vamos a hablar espiritualmente. ¿Saben que también tenemos una identidad dada por nuestro Padre Celestial? Y saben, esta identidad muchas personas la desconocen. Y entonces, la pregunta que tú hacías.
¿Por qué es importante conocer a Dios?
Sí, quizás muchos van a decir, pues no sé por qué es importante. Porque, ¿sabes? Quizás ellos aún no han conocido a Dios, aún nadie les ha hablado acerca de Dios. Entonces, ellos no saben la importancia, van a decir, pues, si esta pregunta se la hace, van a decir, pues, no sé, no tengo una idea para qué sea importante. Pues, ¿sabes? Llegamos a entender la importancia hasta cuando lo conocemos, hasta cuando aprendemos a relacionarnos con Dios. Y dices, pero ¿cómo puedo conocer a Dios? ¿Verdad? Aún así, leyendo la Biblia. Pues conociendo al Hijo. Entonces, fíjense, en Juan 1, 12 y 13 dice, mas a cuanto lo recibieron, a los que creen en su nombre, les dio el derecho de ser hijos de Dios. ¿Cómo podemos conocer a Dios Padre? Estamos hablando de el carácter de Dios como Padre. ¿Cómo podemos conocer ese carácter de Dios? Conociendo al Hijo. ¿Saben? Cuando Jesús vino a esta tierra, Caro va a compartirnos con nosotros un poco más de eso, pero cuando Jesús vino a esta tierra, muchos le decían, pero muéstranos al Padre, queremos conocer al Padre. Y Jesús les decía, es que si me ves a mí, ves a mi Padre, porque lo que me has visto hacer a mí, es lo que yo he visto hacer al Padre. Quizás muchos dicen, pero, o sea, ¿cómo puedo conocer a ¿cómo puedo identificar a Dios como Padre si yo realmente nunca tuve un papá? Yo no crecí con un papá. O sea, yo no tuve la oportunidad de conocer a un papá. Pues fíjate, esa es la oportunidad de conocer a, un, a, a un Padre celestial, un Padre perfecto, un Padre que no falla. Y este es el estudio de hoy, es para que cuando nosotros terminemos, tú te quedes con ese deseo de decir, ¿sabes qué? Aunque yo no tuve un papá, yo quiero conocer a ese Padre celestial del cual ellos me hablaron. Ese es el propósito de esta serie, conocer el carácter de Dios como Padre.
I just want to backtrack a little bit a lo que estaba diciendo usted, hermana, de que en las familias se pasa la like culture, traditions, mm-hmm. and all that stuff. Y también se puede decir que también se pasan the morals, o sea, las cosas que son buenas y malas.
Sí.
Y yo creo que una, like an answer to the question that we had earlier of why it's important to know God is because it can be very difficult para distinguir, porque si no tenemos a Dios, nuestra fundación, our foundation on our morals can be anywhere. Mm-hmm. Puede estar donde sea. Y tener a Dios gives us that sturdy foundation, because now before we started filming, we were talking about how that boundary of right and wrong can be very
blurred. Blurred.
Yeah, very blurred. Even you were saying, sometimes it's not even there.
Yeah, exactly.
And the thing is that a lot of times it's based on emotion. And yeah. Even the Bible says, like, you can't trust your heart. You know, you can't trust those emotions because the thing is that they change.
That's true.
You know?
And I mean, like, I think, like, it's normal to have them, but
yeah,
sometimes they stray off either to an extreme where we act upon them.
Yeah.
Is where we tend to, you know, probably make a decision that's good to the way I feel, but because it only feels right to me or good to me, I don't put anyone's else's emotions or their well-being into consideration at times.
Yeah, totally agree. So we're going to jump over to the next part. So let's go into John 14. And it's just like regular John, regular schmegular John. But anyways, so in this chapter, Jesus is being very confusing. Let me just tell you that. He's being kind of confusing. The disciples are like, what are you talking about, sir? But so in these first few verses, I'm going to kind of like paraphrase them in a way. So Jesus is telling the disciples that he is going away to prepare for them a place in the Father's house. And he tells them in verse 4, he says, you know the way that I am going, or you know the way to where I'm going. And to this, one of the disciples says, bruh, I don't even know where you're going. How am I supposed to know the way? Right? And Jesus replies, I am the way. If you know me, you will get to the Father, know the Father, and have seen the Father. And one of the other disciples, his name is Philip, and he says in verse 8, show us the Father, and that's enough for us. And when I read that, it was kind of funny, though, because I kind of imagined it kind of like, you know when you're going to do like a group presentation or something?
Okay.
And the teacher picks you to speak for the group, right?
The worst time, yeah.
Huh, what happened?
I said the worst time, yeah.
Yeah, seriously. And you're kind of like, well, I'm not sure about my answer, so I'm just going to say us, you know? So he was kind of like, oh, yeah, it's enough for us, you know? Kind of like he lumped everyone together so that he wouldn't be the one singled out, right? But this is the thing I love about Jesus. Jesus says to him in verse 9, have I been among you all this time without you knowing me, Philip? Hmm. Like, he straight up, like,
singled
calls him
out.
Yeah. And that's the thing I feel like with Jesus. He doesn't let us be in our confusion. He's like, yeah, no, let's get out of that right now, real quick.
Yeah.
We're just not going to do that. So he says, the one who has seen the Father... So the one who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Right? And then he continues on in verse 11. He says, believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me. Otherwise, believe because the works themselves. And I mean, we all know, you know, what Jesus was doing, right? He was healing the blind, like the lame, the crippled. He was telling them to walk.
Right.
He brought somebody back to life. Like, what? And so... Christ is telling them, you know, what he is claiming, which is him being in the Father and the Father being in him, could be seen, right? So it's not just what he was saying, but it can be seen by the actions that he was doing, right? His works. And that same way, God is calling us to show our faith, you know, who we are by our works, by our actions. But the thing is, and I love about Jesus, that he isn't commanding something that he hasn't done himself. Right, and that he shows us the how, right? So at this point, Jesus was, and I guess you could kind of say he was the friend, right? A friend of the disciples, you could say. But in these verses that we just read, he's challenging them to see him as more than that, as their father, right? So, but the thing is, it's not as like a traditional father,
right?
So let's kind of dig into that a little bit. So my question to you guys now is, what are some characteristics of a traditional good father figure? So, ¿qué son características de un papá bueno?
Un buen padre.
Un buen padre de aquí, o sea, de la tierra.
Yeah. Amoroso.
Amoroso, okay. So let's do three each. So amoroso, what else?
Firm.
Firm, yeah, okay.
Trabajador.
Trabajador, yeah.
I guess assertive, but in a respectful way.
Assertive. So we said firm, assertive. What else?
Loving.
Loving. Works hard.
Yeah.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4.
What's protector.
Protector. What else? One more. Five.
I guess merciful.
Merciful. Okay. Okay, so now let's look at... So would you guys say that the characteristics of an earthly father are the same or different from the heavenly father? So ¿qué dirían ustedes que las características de un padre terrenal son igual o diferente al padre celestial? What do you guys think?
Yo digo que todas las que pusimos son características que Dios tiene.
Yeah.
Porque estamos hablando de un buen padre, porque lo bueno de la pregunta, que fue un buen padre. Por eso creo que todas esas corresponden a Dios Padre.
Yeah, I think they could apply to both. I think the only thing is obviously, right, we're all flawed.
Yeah.
So, although a father might have all those characteristics, but he might be lacking in one of them or more than one. But, yeah, I think if we're going to see the characteristics of our Heavenly Father and our Father here on Earth, I think... Obviously, our Heavenly Father is going to have better characteristics or just outshine, even if our Father also has those good characteristics. And I think it's just, since we're all flawed or we lack in some ways, obviously I don't think we're going to get there, but I think we can always work towards it. Entonces, vamos a, well, I got a little story
that we got here.
So, here's a story, right? So, your best friend, she's in a university. Susie.
What's up, Susie?
Yeah. So she is the second oldest, I guess, out of three siblings. And in a single occasion, Susie, right, she makes a huge mistake.
No, I'm just kidding. A little mistake. I take that back, kids. I'm sorry.
She makes a huge mistake, right? But it was a financial mistake. And it kind of like put almost like her whole family in debt.
She went gambling.
Yeah, I don't know what she did, right?
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, no specifics, but yeah, the situation, right, where she made this mistake, this huge financial mistake, and basically it's like destroying family financially, right? And because of this, right, this mistake that she made, her mom and her dad, like they throw it in her face, right? They throw it in her face. They talk to her in a negative way, in offensive ways, and they even hurt her physically as well. So, Susie, obviously, she was feeling just distraught. She had this pain, and not just emotionally, like physically, obviously, she was physically beat.
Yeah.
And after this, she just started to think that if her parents don't appreciate her, like if they don't have any like positive feelings towards her, like her life isn't worth anything. So... After she had heard, right, in this situation where you're her friend, she heard you talk about God and how God is a loving father, right? And which to her didn't really make much sense because, you know, her parents are constantly offending her and putting her down. So that's sort of her situation right now. And obviously this is a scenario, this is not real. I have some questions as far as it's gotten so far in this situation, right? And these are the questions I'm gonna ask both of you: Is How could Susie change the image that she has for her parents in a positive way?
Y la pregunta será aquí, que es, ¿cómo podría Susie cambiar la imagen que tiene para sus padres para que sea buena?
A través de esa situación donde ella cometió un error de una manera grave, financiera, ¿verdad? Que donde la familia ahora está en una deuda grande, fue maltratada. ¿Y cómo ella podrá cambiar esa imagen que tiene a sus padres? Porque ella, cuando escuchó de Dios que es un buen padre, para ella no tiene sentido, porque ella no ve eso en la casa.
Conociendo a Dios.
¿Conociendo a Dios?
¿Cómo?
Ok, conociendo a Dios porque, o sea, la imagen que ella tiene de sus padres, pues como ya lo dijimos, o sea, es muy diferente. Ella dice, o sea, ¿cómo Dios, o cómo vienes tú y me dices que Dios me ama, que Dios es bueno, que esto, si los que son realmente mis papás no me aman, me golpean, me hablan mal, me tratan mal, ¿cómo es que Dios, que no me conoce, o sea, puede amarme?
Sí.
Entonces, pues, si estuviera Susi, yo le dijera, Susi, Dios sí te conoce, Dios te creó desde el vientre de su madre, desde el vientre de tu madre te creó, Él te formó, y Él tiene un propósito y un plan para ti. Ahora es tiempo de que tú le des la oportunidad de que tú le conozcas. Uh-huh. Yo sé que es difícil la situación que ella está pasando, pero ese sería mi consejo. O sea, tienes que conocer a Dios. ¿Sabes? Tus papás se equivocan, al igual que nosotros nos equivocamos. Yo todos los días me equivoco, cometo errores. Pero tenemos que siempre ver a alguien que es mejor que nosotros, y en este caso es Dios. Dios no se equivoca, Dios es real, porque a veces también decimos, no, es que aquí ni Dios me puede ayudar, porque no conocemos al Dios real, no conocemos al Dios del que dice la Biblia que era desde el principio, el que abrió el mar y todo eso. Creemos que es mito, es una historia bien bonita y le cerramos la Biblia. No, Dios es... hasta hoy es el mismo Dios. Entonces, pero eso tenemos que conocerlo. Y Susi se tendría que dar la oportunidad de conocer a Dios.
Yeah. I think también, o sea, eso también, that she should give herself an opportunity to know God, but also give that situation up to God. Because it's not, I mean, this situation is a very difficult situation to be in a house where you're being beat. And I don't know if it's like to the point where she's, I mean, I'm guessing, does it say like she's physically...
She's bruised.
Okay. I don't know. That's kind of a really difficult situation.
It is. It is.
You know, it's like that's
and
not...
And it's an extreme case, you know, but
yeah.
It's just...
I think definitely you'd be... Know God, you know, and know His power and give that situation up to God.
Right.
You know, because like we said, we can't change people, right? No. And the thing is, only God can. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I would just say to give that situation up to God, and I just maybe, I don't know, like to try not to be in that situation where you're
right.
being beat, because that's
right.
not.
Of course, no, it's not healthy to stay
yeah,
there.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, obviously, this is all we have. We don't really know whether if she can or if she can't leave.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't know how old she is or how young she is. But I think another huge thing, and I think that's a huge part of what you guys said, is get to know God. And let's just say in this situation, sadly, she can't leave,
mm-hmm.
right? Because obviously we wouldn't want her to stay there.
Yeah.
But another thing I think would be able to help her out is, after getting to know God, being able to forgive.
That's a big one.
Because
yeah,
although it's gonna be hard, because I mean we've all been hurt and we've offended,
yeah.
and probably not even to this degree.
Yeah.
And we have difficulty forgiving people who've
mm-hmm.
hurt us. And the thing is that's. Although I think we've all been in the situation where we do manage to forgive people who hurt us
yeah.
and also ask for forgiveness because sometimes we're really bad at that too.
Yeah.
But when we actually forgive them truly, we have this...
It's so freeing.
Yeah, it's freeing. And it's like the chains have been broken. You just don't have that weight on you anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Although things still might not be great, right? Because just because I forgive someone, that doesn't mean my problems are gone. Right, but at least I don't have that burden, emotional
no,
burden
right.
on myself that I put on.
Yeah.
Right, other people might try to, you know, get to me, but I can have the opportunity of not to get to myself.
Yeah.
So I think that would be
something really helpful for her as well.
And I think really quickly, like, I want to go into like the idea or like the what the Bible says about mercy and grace, you know, and how important that is, you know, because like you said, it can be freeing, and that's something right. that like God helps us do, you know, and that's why there's so many songs that say my chains have been broken, they're gone, they're no longer here, you know, and that's just so powerful.
Yeah.
And it's just like sometimes we kind of, I guess maybe because of how much we listen or hear about mercy and grace, we don't understand how powerful that is, you know? And I think that's one of the huge aspects, I guess, of like, I don't know, just like the love of God, you know, that he loves us so much, that he is so loving and merciful and graceful to us. And he has so much grace for us, because the thing is, like, I mean, we're all sinners, you know? And it's just like being able to come back to a father who, I don't know, just this crazy powerful, has the power to literally spite, like if he was just like, yeah, I don't want you anymore, I could literally die right now, but yet he doesn't do that,
right?
You know, and I think that's just, I don't know, if you really think about it, I feel like it's so mind-blowing, you know, to have somebody like that with you. Mm-hmm. You know.
Yeah, and the second question is, how can we or us as a church, like, what's a way that we could get these, personify or get these characteristics of Christ, so that we could see in this situation, Susie, right, her father as a loving father. Mm. Like, what can we do as a church?
To be able to do that?
Yeah, to be able to help out in this situation. ¿Qué podríamos hacer como iglesia que podamos ayudar en esta situación a Susie, ¿verdad? Que vea las características o personalidades de Cristo, de Dios, para que vea a su padre o que vea ese cambio en su padre, como un padre amoroso.
Sí, pues por nuestro ejemplo, o sea, quizás Susie vamos a ponerle cara, nombre y hasta la escuela, quizás va en tu misma escuela, ¿verdad? Y fíjate qué bonito fuera que Susi se acerca a ti porque en ti ve algo diferente. Sabes que yo veo en él o en ella algo diferente, algo que yo sé que puedo confiar en ella, que puedo, y que de tu boca va a salir un buen consejo. Decir, ¿sabes qué? Yo te puedo aconsejar, pero yo sé un lugar, yo conozco un lugar donde te podemos ayudar, un lugar donde vas a conocer personas diferentes a lo que hasta este momento has conocido. Entonces, es por tu ejemplo, y es el mejor ejemplo que tenemos nosotros para mostrar el carácter de Dios. Uh-huh. O sea, porque podemos venir a la iglesia, pero si la gente allá afuera no ve algo diferente en nosotros, o sea, ¿dónde está? ¿Dónde estamos parados nosotros? Entonces, creo que es por nuestra forma de ser.
I completely agree. And just to kind of put a verse to that, I guess we could go back to that first verse that we read in the beginning. 1 John 3:1, it says, look at how great a love the Father has given us, that we should be called God's children, right? And then it says, and we are, the reason the world does not know us is that it didn't know him. And I think that goes back to what the hermana was saying earlier about being a child of your parents, right? Mm-hmm. You like kind of in a way inherit, I guess, certain, what is it, like cultural traditions. Mm-hmm. And that same thing goes for God's children, right? Like Jesus tells us, and we're told, you know, in the Bible and all that stuff,
right,
to walk as he walked, you know? So I think a big thing, como dice usted, is to do that, mm-hmm, you know, to see those expectations and be like, that's what I'm going to do. Because it's not just for you, it's for everybody else. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because we are the living, breathing, well, not living because Jesus is alive, but I mean like the earthly, I guess you could say, like representations of Jesus, right? Right. And the thing is, and it's kind of funny, because Christians, it used to be kind of not a slang, but kind of like a, oh, like.
Like a ridicule term.
Yeah, a ridicule, because it used to mean literally little Christ. Yeah. Like, oh, you little Christ. You know what I mean? And that's literally what we're supposed to be.
Yeah.
You know, like little Christians, like little Jesus is walking around, you know? And yeah, I just think that's exactly what it is. We have to like represent him. But I think something really important that you said that I really want to highlight is to be real. You know what I mean? Like, don't try to put a pretty face. Because the thing is, like, yes, God knows your struggle, but he still wants you to come to him.
Right.
You know what I mean? And be, like, as intimate as you can. Because that's what that's where you find God, I feel like, the most. Like, even in that, like, Jesus, you know, like, he was always real with God. Like, he was always, like, it says right here, like, in sus angustias. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, when he was on his lowest low, you know, and he was broken, he came to God. He was like, oh, yeah, God, this is fine. You know, and you know what I mean? Like, kind of like putting up a face. Mm-hmm. That's not what God wants. He wants you to be real.
Right.
He wants you to come to him, mm-hmm. you know? But, yeah.
Sí. Bueno, pues vamos a orar para terminar nuestra lección. Gracias a todos los que nos estuvieron acompañando, pues hasta que Dios lo permita y podamos estar juntos, vamos a seguir así. Entonces, estén al pendiente de todos los enlaces en vivo que vamos a tener para que no se pierdan nada de, pues, de las enseñanzas que vamos a traer. Y bueno, vamos a orar. Gracias, Jesús, te doy por esta oportunidad que nos has dado, Señor, de estar juntos, porque queremos aprender cada día más de ti. Hoy hemos aprendido, Señor, acerca de cómo eres tú como Padre. Quizás, como lo hemos repetido, Señor, algunos de los que nos escuchan no tuvieron la oportunidad de tener un padre, o no tienen ese padre que puedan ellos tener el mejor ejemplo en la tierra, Señor, pero tú, por medio de tu palabra, te muestras, Señor, como el Padre perfecto. Señor, ayúdanos a conocerte tal y como tú eres, Padre, por medio de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, que Él vino a esta tierra, Señor, y se mostró tal cual es. Muéstranos, Señor, cómo quieres que seamos nosotros, Señor, que la gente nos mire a nosotros, que cuando la gente nos mire vea que somos tus hijos, que seamos reconocidos, Señor, que ellos sientan el deseo de estar con nosotros porque ven algo diferente, Señor, y eso diferente eres tú, Señor, el que estás con nosotros, el que nos ayudas a seguir adelante. Señor, muéstrame cuál es el propósito, cuál es el plan que tienes para mí. ¿Por qué me creaste, Señor? ¿Por qué me elegiste como tu hijo? Gracias por eso. Gracias porque mandaste a Jesús para hacerme libre, Señor, de la esclavitud, del pecado. Gracias, Señor, porque dice tu palabra que si reconocemos a Jesús como nuestro Salvador, si creemos que Jesús es tu hijo y que Él murió por nuestros pecados y que Él resucitó, nos hacemos hijos tuyos, Señor, y queremos que los que aún no te conocen, Padre, que no han conocido a este Padre celestial, Señor, que puede cambiar nuestras vidas, Señor, te conozcan en este momento. Los que estamos aquí hemos reconocido que tú eres Dios, que tú eres el Padre amoroso, protector, todo lo que hemos dicho, Señor, pero hay muchos allá afuera que aún no te conocen. Te damos las gracias por todo lo que haces y lo que harás. En el nombre de Cristo Jesús, amén y amén.
Hold on! I know we prayed, but listen, you guys are champions, the ones that stayed. Now, okay, so this is going to be on Apple Podcasts, on Spotify, and for those of you that want to see us, our beautiful faces, obviously,
right.
It's going to be up on YouTube if you want to hear us and see us, because, you know, we miss you too.
Make sure you hit that like.
Oh, yeah, like it, please. And you know what? For those of you that stayed, I want you guys to comment down below. What should they do?
I don't know. Comment who has a better shirt.
Ooh, competition. Look, mine is Paris, bro.
Nah.
So, yeah, anyways. Comment down below who had the nicest. Just literally put our name.
Yeah.
And let everybody else be confused. So comment down below if you watch this on YouTube. Write that on the comments. And then if we did, if you're listening through Apple or Spotify, comment on our last, on our post on Instagram.
Right.
About this podcast.
There'll be a link to it.
Sorry?
There'll be a link to our Instagram.
Yes, a link to our Instagram. And our Instagram is, for those of you who are awesome, it's _impact_youth_group. It's going to be there. So yeah, go follow us.
And on the screen.
There you go. So go follow us. Leave that comment down below if you're listening through Apple or Spotify. But I don't know. Anything else you got to say, guys?
Every single one of you have a beautiful and blessed night.
Yes. Keep a lookout for next week. Bye.
Bye.